Na een spannende tweede seizoen van The Voice Zuid-Afrika is Craig Lucas zondagavond als die winner gekroon. Craig is vanavond hier om voor ons een paar geheimen te vertellen over wat alles achter die scherms op The Voice gebeurt en om te gesels over zijn toekomstplannen. Welcome, Craig.
Hey, thank you so much.
Thanks for being
me.
Here and congratulations to
thank you.
You blew the judges away immediately with your talent and the public was behind you 100% of the way. But your talent wasn't the main focus of the show. It was your relationship with your mom. Can you tell us a bit about the influence that she's had on your life and what it was like growing up with a mom like her?
Yeah, so it's been incredible. My mom raised me by herself, often working 3 jobs to sort of just make sure that we get what we need. So it's been so amazing to bring her here. Like prior to The Voice, neither of us had been on a plane or been out of Cape Town. So just bringing her here has been an absolutely incredible experience. And she's literally more famous than I am. People see me, they're like, oh, where's your mom? We're not here for you, we're here to see your mom.
It's like she won The Voice, basically.
Yeah, and she really has. Like, I've done this for her, so we both won.
Brilliant. How did you choose your song for the blind audition?
Yeah, funny enough, because that's one of my mom's favorite songs, and she's always singing it around the house. And I thought, if I'm going to audition for The Voice, I want to take a classic song, and what better song than one that my mom loves.
When you did your blind audition, all the coaches turned. So you had your pick of all 4 of them. What made you decide to go with Khan, besides the fact that he won last year?
I'd gone in there wanting him to turn because he was the one that I wanted. Purely because like there's nobody like Khan Mobi in South Africa. And I think he's successful purely because he's such an individual. And that's the kind of artist I want to be. I don't think I'm like a lot of singers. And for the longest time, I sort of doubted myself and thought that I'm a little weird. People are not going to like me, but he's been so successful. And I think it's because he's an individual. And I wanted him to teach me to love myself for being different. And that's exactly what he's done.
What was the most important thing that you learned from him in the process? And do you think you will go on to learn things from him, even though the TV show is finished now?
Absolutely. He has definitely told me I need to stay in contact with him after the show. But I think the biggest thing is, you know, everybody likes different things and lots of people sing in different ways. Maar an emotionele verband bly maar an emotionele verband. And he's told me, people listen with their ears, but they feel with their hearts. And what you want to do is make that emotional connection. And I think that's something that lots of people have told me I've done. Whenever I sing a song, they've felt it. And going forward in music, I want to make music that people feel. And that's the biggest thing that he's taught me on the show.
Yeah. You've studied politics, philosophy and economics at university. Have you put that on hold now to just focus on the music?
Absolutely. I graduated just like 2 weeks before the live show started. But then I left my job halfway through the show. I was determined that even if I wasn't going to win, I just wanted to jump into music head on. I just thought it was a little unfair to everybody who's been supporting me and voting me just to go back to my desk job, you know. And I wouldn't do either justice if I were to go back to my job and try to do music on the side. So I'm head on into the music industry now and I'm so excited.
What was the desk job?
I was a planner.
Oh, wow.
A digital planner, yeah.
Wow. Tell us about your musical influences, because the songs that you sang on the show, it was nooit hetzelfde nie. So what kind of things influenced you and do you think is going to influence your sound now going forward with the album?
My music influences are really diverse. I'm such a big fan of Freddie Mercury. And Khan hit the nail on the head when he said I'm sort of the love child between John Legend and Freddie Mercury because those are the two guys that I listen to the most. And I also like Kanye West. I listen to rap music. I like, at the moment, Lorde albums on repeat. So I think everybody was just a little different, but still making it in the mainstream.
Yeah.
Those are the kinds of people that influence me.
What has been the biggest surprise for you over the process of being on The Voice South Africa and now in this week that you're the winner, in terms of how people deal with you, your interaction with the media, with fans? What have you been surprised by?
Everybody keeps asking me what it's like to be famous. And in the run-up, as we're in the show, you don't really get to interact with the public a lot. So you see it on social media, but you don't get to experience it physically. And just being stopped and being asked for pictures, I tell my friends, like, don't be silly, nobody's going to stop me, nobody's interested. But it's been so crazy, just like going out to eat something and people just really being interested in talking to you and even just telling you well done, giving you a hug. I was like, are you sure? People call me. I'm like, why are you calling me? Are you sure you want to be speaking to me? Yeah. So that's been one of the most amazing things.
You said that one of the things you want to do with your prize money is to take your mom on holiday somewhere. Mm. You're not going to get time now, but when you can take her, where would you like to take her and why?
I'm not sure yet. I haven't thought about it, but it would be somewhere she wants to go. I like going to quiet places, so I wouldn't want to be anywhere with lots of technology or whatever. So like a nice game reserve would be ideal, but my mom's not an outdoorsy person, so she'd probably drag me to some spa to go get manicures and like massages and all those kinds of things.
Thanks so much for joining us, Craig, and congratulations. We wish you all the best with your
career.
Thank
you so much.